The East African Institute for Fundamental Research is based in Kigali, Rwanda. It's a partner institute of the International Center for Theoretical Physics in Trieste, Italy. I'd like many people to join us and collaborate with us to advance science in Africa, because I believe honestly that we can make Africa great and prosperous by advancing science. Basically, it will develop research in physics in Rwanda, in the East African region, and in Africa as a whole. People that already have a first degree can participate in the masters and then later on go to the PhD program. We also do short courses and workshops in different areas of physics, like in solar cell renewable energy, or also in high energy physics. And apart from this, we also have a visiting scientist program. So you can arrange to visit and work with us and do high quality research with us.
Oh, yes, we are very excited. This is a historical moment for us.
Oh, yes, great.
It's a center that has been created to follow what ICTP has been trying to do in the past few years, is just to create like partner institutes of ICTP to play the role that we play globally in regions. So we started one in Brazil, Rwanda, China, and Mexico. So in that sense, the center here is important for us because this will be our main institution in Africa. And then we try to promote all science in the region, in the old African region, following the model of ICTP. So since we have been successfully working for more than 50 years, so we know what works and we know what doesn't work. And hopefully we can just expand our mission by having this center located in Africa.
So we need to develop a critical mass of people that are able to carry out research at the highest level and make discoveries that will benefit Africa and lead to African development and advancement. Rwanda has a policy of advancement through science, and it makes it the most natural choice to have this institute here in Rwanda at this time.
Governments and policymakers have realized that science is a key partner, a key player in the whole development of countries. It was not appreciated in the past, and it's more and more appreciated now. Some countries more than others, of course, and Rwanda is a good case of the ones who are appreciating more science. What I think they still fail to understand, many of them, not all of them, but many of them, is that they want immediate results. They want to have science, and they want to skip, and they immediately get the applications, and say, we have to do science only to solve our problems, and that's it. And that's the wrong perspective, and of course, I can understand the perspective from the politician point of view, from the policymaker point of view, because they need to bring results, they need to deliver. Scientists, we see it in a completely different way. We know that science is a long-term investment, and so you need to build up that core of basic science in the countries, and then seeing how you get to applications.
In climate change, for example, modeling is used using these theoretical sciences. And we can now know how to predict what is coming later so that we can react accordingly, prepare the policies for the countries or for the communities.
I'm really happy. The place is fantastic, especially the location. Rwanda is a fantastic, amazing place. And I'm happy because I can study in Africa and pursue my studies there.
Well, the advice I will give to young scientists from Africa in particular is, first of all, not to give up their dreams. There are plenty of opportunities now being created, and it is clear in developed countries. It's less clear yet in developing countries, but it will be.